Hola chicos, happy Sunday. It's your girl Cece. I'm back with another video. I haven't vlogged in such a long time, but today's gonna be story time with Cece. I have two stories to tell you. One just happened previously this summer, around July 4th, that weekend. And my cousin Julie and I, he's 13. He's a cool dude. He's awesome. He's so fun and funny. Shout out to Julian, you know, because you're one of my subscribers. And me and him, Julian and I wanted to ask our parents if we could go buy graham crackers for like that night, because it was morning still. We wanted to take our bikes to go, like, you know, go to ShopRite. But we ended up typing in the GPS Stop and Shop. But before this all happened, my aunt Yvette, she was like, oh, you know, let me take you, we could drive there, it's only like a 10-minute drive around the beach house by Brick. And you know, we were like, no, we want to take our bikes, because we love bike riding is my favorite thing to do during the summer with my cousins or family and friends. And they were like, okay, just come back safely. We were supposed to be wearing helmets, but we didn't. And you know, we wanted to buy graham crackers, Hershey chocolate, and marshmallows to have a campfire s'mores type of night with the family, with the fireplace or the fire pit. So we went, they allowed us to go. We thought we typed ShopRite, but we typed in Stop and Shop. We didn't realize that Stop and Shop was not 10 minutes away, because ShopRite was 10 minutes away. Stop and Shop was 3 miles to like 3 to 5 miles. And we biked all that within an hour. It was like from like 6 to 7. And I'm like, oh my, ay Dios mío. We were going to this bodega and I was just like, are we there yet? Because it's taking us a while. And let me tell you this. I had sneakers on. I had the proper attire and everything. Julian had purple Nike slides, my purple Nike slides. I told him to wear sneakers, but no, he didn't listen. But I think we were in our bathing suits still, but we had clothes. I think I had my romper over and he had his bathing suit along with something over like a shirt to cover. And he almost got hit by a car and I almost got hit by a car. But on our way there, we were biking so fast. And I was like, Julian, look at the GPS while, you know, I keep around, like, look around for the cars. And Yvette, my aunt, kept calling us saying like, oh, are you guys here yet? You know, I'm already here. I'm like, we're 3 minutes away. And literally, like, we got lost. The GPS was tracking some different location where it went, like, where it made it longer. I guess we took the longer route. So we finally made it after like an hour. It was around 7 something. And I went to go into the parking lot. And while I was going into the parking lot, there was this car coming. And the car almost hit me. Because first of all, it didn't stop. It didn't signal. And if I hadn't turned, then I would have been hit. But so Julie and I came. We put our bikes outside for a little bit. Ran back in the bodega. And then, you know, to pick up everything that we needed, then came back out. Coco picked us up. My mom was calling. Everybody was mad. And I just didn't know how to explain to them. I'm like, Mom, it was a misunderstanding. I mixed up both of the bodegas. And she was screaming. Like, she was pissed off, bro. She was pissed off. And Julian even heard her screaming on the phone. My mom is loud. So, Mom, if you're watching this, you're probably going to look back and laugh. But Julian and I looked back and laughed, and my family too, after what happened. So Julian was like, oh, you know, you got in trouble so many times. Let me take the blame. I'm like, no, dude, this is my fault. Like, I typed it in wrong. You know, everybody makes mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes. Everybody has them days. But, you know, then my aunt was like, oh, where are you guys? You guys aren't here. So she figured that we did go to the wrong bodega. So Coco came to pick us up. I was bawling my eyes because my mom was mad. She was going to take away my phone, punish me or whatever. And, you know, he was like, it's okay. I even make those mistakes sometimes. So just chill out, calm down. And as soon as we got home, after the like 5 mile bike ride, Yvette hugged me. She didn't judge me or anything. She was just, now we look back and laugh at it. Cause you know, those, I thought I was stupid because I typed in the wrong thing, but I messed up. And you know, she was calm about it. She didn't say anything. Like, she wasn't like, all she was asking was, are you guys okay? Which I love it when somebody's understanding like that. And yeah, that was probably the best and most funniest thing that happened that summer. But I love you, Julian. If you're watching this, shout out to you for, I finally got to share this story. Also, another story that I have is I have two scars. I don't think you guys can see, but there's one right here. It's like a line. I don't know if it's hard to see. And there's one right here. But I'll take pictures and put it up and upload them. So this one, I was younger. I forgot what age I was, maybe like around 7. And I was running away from this little dog, my friend's dog. And the dog was small, you know. I was scared. I don't know why I'm scared of like such a little dog. And I banged my lip. I was running and then I banged my lip into the wall and it just split open. I don't know if my mom, like, they called the doctors, if I went to doctors, I don't remember, or if they just bandaged my lip. It wasn't like that bad. I don't remember if I needed stitches or whatever. And then this one, I could feel it, but it just feels weird every time someone touches it. This one was traumatizing. I was around ages from 3 to 4 years old. I was a toddler. My dumbass, I was jumping on a step stool and I ended up busting my chin open because my like whole face went this way because the chair fell and it split open. And my parents rushed me to the hospital. I was screaming, crying. I didn't know what was happening. I was bleeding. Like, when I see blood, I freak out. It makes me want to like pass out sometimes. Like, it was a lot of blood. And then I remember watching SpongeBob. The doctor was like, oh, calm down, we might need a staple her chin. All I was hearing was different things, that different phrases and words, what the doctors were saying. They were like, oh, we might need a staple her chin, we might need to you get stitches. Luckily they didn't do any of that. I was crying. My mom heard them say that they glued my chin with some special type of glue. I don't know what it's called. And, you know, I'm fine now, but I have these scars for the rest of my life, which, you know, children are dumb. They do dumb things. I'm very accidental prone. I'm clumsy. You know, I don't know how to change that. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Adios.